Hello students, my name is Professor Sonia Bajaj, Head of Department Computer Science and Engineering from G.H. Raisoni University, Saikheda. In this module, we will discuss about white line follower. The aim of this module is to get you familiar with the three white line sensors that are present on Firebird Bot 5. A sensor is a device that is used to measure physical input from its environment and convert that data into a form that could be interpreted by a human or machine. Most of the sensors are electronic, that is, the data is in electronic form. The agenda for discussion of this module is as follows. Firstly, we will discuss about what is a white line sensor. Following it, we will discuss about the working principle of white line sensor. Then, as I had discussed earlier, that we will be dealing with an experiment on this particular module on obstacle detection. So, we will have a discussion on various sensors in Firebird that makes this obstacle detection possible, such as the ultrasonic and IR sensors. And then at last, this module discussion will be concluded by a C code to implement white line sensor for obstacle detection. So, let us first start with introduction to white line sensors. White line sensors are used for detecting white line on the ground surface. White lines are used to give robots sense of localization. White line sensor consists of a highly directional phototransistor for line sensing and bright red LED for the illumination. Due to the directional nature of the photodiode, it does not get affected with ambient light unless it is very bright. Now, let us discuss in detail about the working principle of white line sensor. When the robot is not on the white line, the amount of light reflected is less. Hence, less leakage current flows through the phototransistor. In this case, the line sensor gives an output in the range of 2 volts to 3.3 volts. When the sensor is on a white line, more light gets reflected, resulting in considerable increase in the leakage current, which causes voltage across the sensor to fall between 2 to 0.1 volt. This process could be seen in the figure I shared on the PPT. Power to the red LEDs of white sensor is controlled by PG5 pin of ATmega2560 microcontroller. This pin is used to extend robot's battery life. Switching action of the power control circuit is exactly same as power switching circuit of IR proximity sensors. Line sensors can be permanently turned on by inserting jumper in the jack number 1 to 4. So, this was all about the white line sensors and its working. Now, as I had said earlier that in this module, we would be implementing a task of obstacle detection along with the white line follower. Hence, for understanding how the obstacle detection along with the white line follower works, we need to first have in detail study of various sensors that actually makes this mechanism possible. So, we would first study about various sensors and their functions involved in this process. So, as you can see, the first sensor is the ultrasonic range sensors. You can clearly see in the figure that the Firebird 5 bot is equipped with 5 ultrasonic sensors. Each sensor can sense distance ranging from 6 inches to 254 inches. The ultrasonic sensor transmits a narrow beam of ultrasonic pulse and measures the time taken and measures the time taken for echo of the beam. It gives output proportional to the time taken for the ultrasonic beam to return echo from the obstacle. The next sensor, as you can see in the PPT, is the figure of IR proximity sensors. There are total 8 IR proximity sensors in Firebird 5, which are numbered as 1 to 8 from left to right in clockwise direction. The infrared proximity sensors are used to detect the proximity of any obstacle in the short range. IR proximity sensors have about 10 centimeter of sensing range. These sensors sense the presence of the obstacles in the blind spot region of the sharp IR range sensor. In the absence of the obstacle, there is no reflected light, hence no leakage current will flow through the photodiode and output voltage of the photodiode will be around 3.3 volts. As the obstacle comes closer, more light gets reflected and falls on the photodiode, and leakage current flowing through the photodiode starts to increase, which causes the voltage across the diode to fall. Now, coming on to the last sensor, which is used in this obstacle detection process, is the sharp IR range sensor. The sharp IR range sensor is used for accurate distance measurement, and these are 5 in numbers on the robot as shown in the figure. Sharp IR range sensors consist of IR LED and a linear CCD array, both encapsulated in the housing with precision lens assembly mounted in front of them. IR LED, with the help of the lens, transmits a narrow IR beam. When light hits the obstacle and reflects back to the linear CCD array, depending on the distance from the obstacle, angle of the reflected light varies. This angle is measured using the CCD array to estimate the distance from the obstacle. It gives same response to different color objects as measured. Distance is the function of the angle of reflection and not on the reflected light intensity. So, this was all about the 3 types of sensors, that is the ultrasonic sensor, IR proximity sensor and the sharp IR range sensors, which plays an important role while we are going to implement our task of obstacle detection along with the white line follower. So, I hope the functions of all these 3 sensors are clear to you all. And now, moving on further in this module, we will see the C code for white line following with obstacle detection. As you can see in the figure, the problem statement to write a particular C code is actually the task on which we are going to work on, and so the scenario of that task needs to be clear in our mind before we start writing a code. So, I have just tried to make you understand the whole setup for this particular problem statement with the help of a figure, as you can see in the PPT. So, from that figure you can derive the problem statement as we need to write a program to move the Firebird over the white line and stop when the obstacle is detected. Also, flash the message on the LCD screen stating the distance between the bot and the obstacle. So, in the figure you can clearly see that there is a start point and there is an obstacle mentioned in the figure. I have just, for example, taken the distance of the accessory box and between that start point is 30 centimeter. Also, there is a white line strip you can see which will be followed by a bot to make the process through this particular way, to make its way. A white line strip is provided. So, let us move on to the C code. Now, before we move on to the C code, there are few pins which you need to keep in mind. Those are the ADC channel numbers. These ADC channel numbers are those pins to which the sharp sensors are connected. So, in obstacle detection, the concept of ADC also plays an important role. Why this ADC plays an important role is because the Firebird 5 consists of 8 IR proximity sensors, 5 sharp IR sensors and 3 white line sensors, and all these sensors provide an analog output. Therefore, to convert this analog data to digital, we require this ADC process also to be involved in this obstacle detection task. So, ATMEGA 2560 is a microcontroller which will perform this task of ADC conversion. The front sharp sensors and the 3 white line sensors are connected to the channel numbers, as you can see in the table. You can see that there are microcontroller pin numbers 96, 95, 94 and 86, which are connected to the ADC channel number 1, 2, 3 and 11 respectively. So, in this whole process of obstacle detection, we need to set up an LED, we need to initialize the port, we need to implement the module of analog to digital conversion, and then finally, we need to set the range, or we need to make the connections for the sensors so that this obstacle detection would be possible. So, coming on to the start of the code, firstly, I have included all the header files. These are the normal header files as we usually write in the C code for Firebird 5 bot, that is avr/io.h interrupt and utility delay.h. I have also included a header file named as math.h over here to support the power function, and as we need to display the distance between the obstacle and the bot, so we require that distance to be displayed onto the LCD. So, for that purpose, we have included a header file named as lcd.h. Then after we have included all the header files, the next step is to initialize the port. Here I have also used a timer port and for velocity control and a motor delay function. As I already said that we will require an ADC conversion, so a particular port has been assigned for that ADC conversion as well. And then there is a left white line, a character variable is declared for left white line and for right white line as well as for center white line. Then coming on to the next function is to configure the LCD port, and it is a normal configuration as you have seen in the earlier modules as well. The port values are also the same as we require to display any message onto the LCD. If you are not clear about how to configure the LCD port, you can refer to the LCD module in this particular lecture series. So, you can go back to that particular LCD interfacing module and you can clear your doubts if you are not getting how I have configured the LCD port. Then next part is the ADC pin configuration, in which we have again taken DDRF equals to 0x00, that is the port F, and DDRK equals to 0x00, that is the port K. Then next step is to configure the ports to enable the robot's motion. In that particular robot's motion, we have included a function called as motion_pin_config. This particular function is used to set the PL3 and PL4 pins as output for pulse width modulation generation. Again, the concept of how to configure this particular function, for this you can refer to the module of PWM generation in the same lecture series. Then comes the function to initialize the ports. We have initialized the port for LCD, for ADC pin and for motion pin. And then the timer 5 is used for PWM in again PWM mode for velocity control. Then the various timers and their values, all for right motor and the left motor, all these things are again has been explained in detail in your PWM generation module from the same lecture series. So, you can refer that. And then comes your ADC_INIT. This is particularly analog to digital conversion, and based on the values which were earlier reflected in the table, based on those values we have assign those values to a particular port, so that this ADC mechanism would be possible. So, you can see over here ADC SRA, ADC SRB, AD MUX, AC SR and ADC SRA are the various analog to digital conversion pins onto which the values has been sent depending on the table values or the pins to which the sensors are connected to. Then we have called a function named ADC underscore INIT, which is used to perform the complete process of analog to digital conversion. As I said, that the sensor is going to provide you output in the form of analog data. So, this analog data needs to be converted to digital. So, this whole process is done by this function for ADC conversion. After this conversion is done, then we need to configure an LCD so that it would be able to print the value onto the screen. So, you can see that there is a function to print the sensor values at desired row and column location on LCD. So, for that particular purpose, we have again defined a function called as void print underscore sensor, and we have passed values to it, parameters of character row, column and character channel to it. Then comes the function for setting the motor's direction. Again, to set the motor's direction, we have used port A in its original status, and making the lower direction nibble to 0, we have then restored the port A status by executing a command called as port A equals to port at restore. Then in order to move the motor forward, again we have set a motion, and to stop the bot, we have again used another function called as void stop. Then at last, after all the functions and ports have been initialized, we need to set the INIT devices. For that, as I had discussed with you in my earlier modules as well, that you first need to clear all the global interrupts and then you need to enable the global interrupts. So, that particular process, for that particular process, the CLI and SEI commands are used. So, same thing we have done over here also. Then coming on to the last part, which is the main program part, in that we have again called the various functions that we have defined earlier for LCD, motion pin, motion timer, ADC conversion and LCD. And then we have used a loop to get this process on until an obstacle is detected. And then we have also used condition over here based on the value of the sharp sensor, sharp underscore sensor less than equals to 100. If any obstacle is in front of firebird, then both the motor should stop. So, for that particular purpose, we have used this if condition over here, if sharp underscore sensor is less than equals to 100. Now, if this is when, if any obstacle is there in front of firebird, but when no obstacle is there in front of firebird, then this loop should run or the bot should move in a forward direction. So, we have given here else, which is used to track the white line and run the firebird. So, as soon as any obstacle is detected, then in that case your firebird should stop or the sensor should sense it and the distance should be displayed onto the screen. So, if center underscore sensor is less than threshold, then we need to change the velocity value. If left sensor is greater than the threshold value, then we need to move it forward. So, again the velocity value will be changed, and if the right sensor is greater than threshold, then the velocity value will be 50, 130. So, these are basically the four conditions based on which the firebird would move in a white line, and it would detect the obstacle based on the value that is sensed by your sensor. So, that is why we have used all the if statements on these sensors values. We have used it for the values of center sensor, left sensor and right sensor, and if no value is detected, then in that case the firebird will keep on moving or following that white line. So, basically this whole process starts with reading the three white line sensor values and taking the decision as per the if statements that we have defined in our main program. All the values are read from the front sharp sensor, and then accordingly those are fed into these if statements, and based on the condition, whichever condition is true, the statements or the code written under those curly braces gets executed. So, this is how an obstacle, we have implemented a C code for an obstacle detection. And the after burning this program onto the firebird, this is what we have got the output as. You can see it in the video below.